I'm surrounded by thousands of different animal species, of which more than 100 are seen as venomous. We've now released a new publication in which we describe an animal-friendly way of studying the toxin genes, so the genes that produce this venom, which opens up many new ways of studying animal venoms. I will now try to tell a story about the venom of this scorpion while it's on my hand. So wish me luck. There's still great mystery surrounding the venoms of venomous animals. What we do know is that they consist of dozens to over 100 different compounds called toxins. And these toxins can heavily affect various systems in the body, such as the blood circulation and nervous transfer. Oh. Super interesting and useful, of course, as these venomous animals might be a useful source for finding new medicine, for example, against heart disease. This is why an international team of scientists from the University of Porto, the Vrije Universiteit Amsterdam, linked to Naturalis Biodiversity Center and Leiden University joined forces. We succeeded in applying a technique called transcriptomics on the venom of the Vietnam forest scorpion, which allows us to study gene expression of the toxin genes that make up this venom. This means there is no need to sacrifice the animal to study the gene expression of the venom gland. We can now study the gene expression of the same scorpion over a longer period of time, meaning that we can look at how certain factors, such as age, season, and stress levels, may affect the venom. But how does this work? Some animals, like this snake, and other animals, such as this centipede, have venom-producing cells that release their venom into the storage space of the venom gland in small vesicles, resulting in a very clean venom. Other animals, such as this beautiful scorpion, have their venom gland squeezed or even entirely disintegrated, resulting in a venom with a lot of cell debris. And it's exactly this cell material that we need to be able to look at the gene expression in the venom gland using transcriptomics. The method of venom production explains why this technique is not likely to work for snakes, but does work with scorpion venoms. And even though this technique might not be suitable for all venomous animals, it still offers many new possibilities in venom research. An interesting example of venom variation can be found in spiders. Take the Australian fauna web spider. The venom of male spiders changes tremendously over the course of their lives. From a predatory venom that is used to catch insects, to a defensive venom that these spiders develop during the mating season, when they leave the safety of their burrows to start looking for a female, and that better protects them against potential predators. This new technique allows us to answer questions such as how this slow lowers its venom changes in response to age, diet, or stress, and where the lionfish on tropical reefs produce a different venom in response to climate change. Imagine the endless possibilities that this new technique allows us to explore.